Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales. I'm the RPG chick. Let's head back to the tavern. I have chocolate for you.
Hello, Sloth.
Ah, Wilbur. Greetings.
See you, Sloth.
Hold on a second.
So long.
Which one do I actually have? I have the blue one. I always do that to make sure it's there. Now what if I tell him I have one of the red ones?
Ah!
Red. I brought you one of the red chocolates from the bakery.
Look, I got you a chocolate.
Ah, well, the thought was there, but those are the wrong ones. The red ones contain alcohol.
Alcohol makes Sloth tired.
I'm afraid that's true. I only eat the blue ones without alcohol.
Oh, well. I meant well.
I got you one of the blue chocolates from the bakery.
Look, I got you a chocolate.
That's why I saved it.
Oh, that's fantastic. Thank you. Mmm, fantastic.
See? That's the way mages help one another. One wants a chocolate after closing, the other needs help with a golem.
I'm sorry, Wilbur. I can't help you, even if I wanted to. I haven't kept a single part.
Psst, Wilbur.
Not that again. And no, I won't put my hands over my ears.
He has a torso, doesn't he? I brought you another of your favorite chocolates. I did.
Here, another one of your favorite chocolates.
Oh, you're a real friend.
What am I giving him?
Mmm. Oh, yeah.
Hey, my pleasure. See you, Sloth.
So long.
Because I had two of them? Alright, yeah, that's that. Okay. What? I always hit escape to get out of that, and ugh. Yeah, we need to get the two chocolates and wrap one with the other. Well, that's up here, isn't it? No, wait, wait. It's down here. Oh, no, it's past the gate. I'm forgetting things. Sorry, guys. Where is it? No, it's not here. Wait, wait, it is here. We need to get one and wrap it with a different...
I think we need another chocolate.
No problem. Which color?
We're gonna need both.
One red one, please.
Okay.
What we're going to do is wrap it, switch the wrappers, so that we end up giving him the alcoholic one. Then he goes seepies.
Up onto the roof.
Right? He goes seepies, and then we, Blout will tell us the secret. And we'll advance in the story.
Catch!
Okay, so we need a blue one now.
The drain's blocked by a grate.
No, him. Thank you.
think we could use another chocolate. A blue one this time.
Okay.
So what do you think of the game so far, guys?
There he goes, up onto the roof.
Are you glad you can hear the voices better? As he says, there he goes into the roof when he's already inside the shop.
Catch.
I think it's great. And there's some, you know, some stuff. There's dialogue missing, mostly. But that's not that big of a deal.
Good work!
Just kind of pulls you out of the game, you know?
Right. I'll just swap the blue and red wrappers.
Exactly.
Done.
Chocolate without alcohol.
The chocolate without alcohol is now wrapped in the red paper, and the one with alcohol is wrapped in the blue. The chocolate without alcohol is now wrapped in the...
You know. Okay. Back to the Shea Luger. Rather than talk to him, I'll just go like this. Painting alcohol. Give to Zloff. He likes.
Do you want another one of your favorite alcohol-free chocolates?
Liar.
Oh, of course. Oops.
What? Ooh.
Ouch.
Zloff KO. Very clever plan, Willie.
That's not what I was planning on doing, but, should we call a doctor?
That was a pretty hard thump. Perhaps we'd better call a doctor.
Bro, ogre skull unbashable.
Okay, fine. If you say so.
What did you want, Blout?
What did you want to tell me, Blout? I hope it was worth it.
Blout has golem.
You do?
Or... part of golem.
I only need part.
Your brother's golem?
The torso part.
No, other golem. Blout bought it.
Why did you buy the golem? And why shouldn't Zloff know about it?
Why did you buy a golem? And why don't you want Zloff to know anything about it?
Zloff always so much work. Much stress. Much row. Blout scared to fight more. Zloff leave him one day.
right.
How would that work?
That's why Blout by Golem should help in inn. Zloff and Blout have holiday.
I see. And since Zloff had some bad experiences building golems, you wanted to keep it secret until it's finished.
So where's the golem?
Where is the golem? Or the parts?
Here. Is broken.
Yes, I see that.
Blout buy more parts, then shout at until golem come alive.
I don't think that will work.
Yes, Zloff hear and complain. Blout should not play with magic fingers. Willibur must build golem. Then Blout stop making fun of Willibur's size.
You never made fun of my size.
Willibur so small, mice call him dwarf. Blout not say again if Willibur help.
Oh, God.
Okay. Fine. How about this? I'll help you out and build the golem, but it's mine until the election, and I can do what I want with it. I'll bring it back after the election, and the golem can help you and Zloff here in the inn.
Okay.
Okay. Well, I guess it won't be guarding the Archmage Alistair, then.
What happened?
Zloff, sleepyhead.
See you later, Blout.
Well, let's check it out. All we need is a torso, right?
Fantastic. What have we here? A torso and nothing else.
Perfect.
Arms, legs, and head are missing. A few old notes have fallen out of it. Mow the lawn, wash the dishes, chop a basket full of firewood, then do nothing. Find the Holy Grail in the castle of Arg.
Find the dragon sweat
stop.
Here.
By the gods, stop right this moment. These must be old commands that someone put in the golem's mouth.
Oh, yeah. True.
The torso appears to be in good shape, except the fact that it's broken off at the hip. I'd say it's made of some kind of stone. Looks pretty heavy, even though it's hollow. I guess it's best if I leave it lying where it is and then add the missing pieces here.
Oh, well, we can do that.
The torso appears... I'd say... I guess it's best if I leave...
Touch the head.
I think I did a pretty good job on the head.
Maybe.
I'm making progress. It already has a head. Still needs arms and legs, though.
Arms.
I'm almost done. Just a couple of legs and I'll have built the perfect golem.
Okay. Funny legs.
And now the golem's body is finished. All that is missing is a spell written with magic ink for its mouth.
Right, which I still need. More chocolate. Bribe the professor.
I don't need to talk to Sloth at the moment.
We need to find dragon sweat.
I don't have anything to talk to Blout about right now. Hey, Master Block?
Yes.
The door of the staff room uses voice recognition?
Apparently, it's not enough to just know the staff room door code. You have to have been introduced to the door, too.
Correct. The door knows by means of the voice who has access and who doesn't.
And who has access?
At the moment, only me.
That doesn't seem fair. Bye.
Have to be going.
Goodbye.
My first homemade golem. Looks cracking. All I have to do now is put a spell written in magic ink in its mouth to bring it to life.
Insert. Now, what we could really use is the baby critter from the Critter Chronicles game to record his voice, but he'd have to say the access code still, so that wouldn't even work. Now let's look around, see if we can find any... Nothing to look at around here. Mr. Shieldhand, you know where to find Dragon Sweat?
The less I talk to him, the better. Almost every house in the lot.
Can we get another chocolate? Maybe we'll need it.
I think we could use another chocolate. A blue one this time. Okay.
I wonder if X has broken out of the prison yet.
There he goes, up onto the roof.
No, he's inside.
Catch.
All right.
I should chat with X's.
Alright. So there's nothing else to look at here, right? Anything new going on with the posters? They removed the protest sign?
The lookout is reporting unfairly and someone has... No wonder...
I wonder if I can put it back again. Still have it.
The less I talk to him, the better.
But we've put it back up. Okay, let's go. Nothing else new about this, right?
I wonder if Zloff would help me with a goal.
I really need those.
Hello, Bill.
Dragon sweat.
Wilbur. Sell dragon sweat? Dragon sweat? I was afraid of that, but I need it badly. I mean expensive, like... I have to be going, Bill. See ya.
Well, I don't rightly know what to do.
Friedelin may have nibbled on it, but it's still...
Alright, guys, I'm not sure what to do now. I have to either think about this or start clicking random things on different people and seeing what happens. I'll be back. Okay. Came across this.
What can I do for you?
Can you imitate voices?
Can you imitate voices?
I can imitate the call of more than 17 birds.
We don't need that.
I'm more interested in human voices.
I am sorry. I only have one voice at my disposal. A very pretty voice.
It sure is.
Oh, of course.
I can, however, record speech.
Record speech? What do you mean? Record speech? What do you mean? Fantastic.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. Okay, you can stop now.
Do it again.
How does this recording thing work?
I can record all of your conversations. If desired, I can play back only certain parts of the recording.
You mean that if I can somehow get the headmaster to say 4, 60, 9, and 41 in conversation, you could repeat those numbers in his voice?
Correct.
Excellent.
Which numbers have we already recorded? None.
4, 60, 9, and 41 are the numbers we need. Which ones do we have?
None of the stated numbers have been recorded yet.
Wah, wah. Oh,
that's not very many.
That's all.
I might have some more questions for you later.
And I might answer.
You best to answer. All right, let's go back down to the pub. Oh, we don't need that. We need...
One of the first clues that demons were in the cameras was that those photographs made strange grimaces they would never make in reality. A number of the students in this photo look more than odd. The graduating class of 1462 is written in ornate script above the image.
1462. Hold up.
What can I do for you?
4, 6, 9, and 41
are
the numbers we need.
1462?
Which ones do
we
have?
None of the state...
Wow.
Huh. Maybe if we did 14, we just cut off the 4 and he'll say 4 like that.
I might have some more questions for you later.
Okay. I mean, other than that, it's going to be two dialogue. Hey, can you say some numbers for me?
Hey, Master Block?
Yes.
Why are you... what are you drinking?
A clear liquid, in a glass, in a bar. What could it be?
Water.
Sure, why not? A nice glass of cold water.
It's warm water. I drink 2 glasses of warm water every evening. It helps the digestive process.
Do we need 2?
Why don't you drink 3 glasses of water? Or 4?
4 glasses of water in one evening?
Ah.
That really would be decadent.
We got 5.
Besides,
I mean 4.
You'd probably have to keep getting out of bed to go to the toilet.
Why did I say 5?
Yes. 4 glasses of water would simply be too many.
But it's good that we were able to talk about that.
Yeah, really? Is it recording?
Have to be going.
Goodbye.
Do I have to set it in record mode? Hold on a second.
What can I do for you?
464.
That's all.
It's a start.
What numbers again?
4, 6, 9, and 41 are the numbers we need.
69 and 41.
4.
That's all.
It's a start.
Okay.
I might have some more
And...
Hey, Master Block?
Yes?
Can you say 9?
Would you please say the word 9, Headmaster Block?
No. Why should I?
Just because?
Professor Weathervane, it may be that you pass your evenings with silliness, but I prefer to be productive in the twilight hours.
9.
Of course. Forgive me.
9, damn you. I really fancy a dwarven ale.
Ooh, I could really go for a nice dwarven ale about now. How about you?
It would kill you on the spot. You do know that.
Oh, I grew up with dwarfs. The cellar master always served dwarven ale in the garrison pub.
It's strictly forbidden.
Hmm.
Who says?
Licensing law, paragraph 9, section 1. Dwarven ale may only be served in specially secured underground bunkers.
Paragraph 9 says that.
Paragraph 9, indeed.
Ah, the cellar master probably didn't know that. I'm going to send a carrier pigeon off to him tomorrow morning to warn him. Have to be going.
Goodbye.
So now we got these 2. Sorry, I know I'm going the long way around, but...
What can I...
4, 6, 4, 9.
That's all.
2 down, 2 to go.
Hmm.
I might have some more...
And...
Oops.
Hey, Master Block?
Yes?
Why were you chosen as treasurer?
Why did they appoint you, of all people, treasurer?
Well, I think the leader of the council values my punctilious manner and neat bookkeeping. In addition, I was, if I may be so bold as to simply come out and say it, mathematics champion for several years in succession in my youth.
Oh, give him a formula. So you're a math champion? I've got a problem for you.
So, you were a mathematics champion in your youth?
For several years in succession, in fact.
Hmm. Then tell me, what is...
What are we trying? Which number are we trying to get? Well, we can go for 60 or 41. 37 plus...
37 plus...
Hold on a second. 23? 23. Oh!
23 minus...
0.
33?
27.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, look at the class photo then.
This photograph of a school class was in the wrong cupboard. I'd like to file it away correctly, but I don't know where.
Show me that. The year is written boldly and clearly. 1462.
62?
Yes. 62.
All right, we got 60.
Ah, thanks for your help.
So I was gunning for 60 originally.
I'm amazed by your math skills. I have one more problem for you.
Well, all right then.
What is...
I'm stuck in this mode. I gotta go for 41.
Thirty-seven plus...
I hate math.
Fifty minus...
So we've got... what? 37 plus 50, 87, minus...
42.
Ugh, one
really?
Off.
I'm amazed by your math skills.
Well...
What is... 37 plus... 50 minus... 47?
That's not gonna be it.
40.
Really?
Well, we got 40. If we just make him say one now.
I'm amazed by your...
Well...
What is...
17,
17 minus...
I hate this. This will be negative 10.
27 plus... 47?
It's not gonna be it.
37.
Really? I'm amazed.
Well,
what is?
I'm really mad at these game designers making me do math.
65 plus...
65 plus... 23. Okay, this would be 88.
23 minus...
88
47. 41. Are you sure? I get 40.
41 without a doubt.
Thanks. That's all I wanted.
We've got some double recordings. Now I'm done.
Have to be going.
Goodbye.
Got everything, Magic Sleep?
What can I do for you?
Which numbers have we already recorded?
460.
469. 41.
Now we have all of the numbers.
Da-da-da.
Staff room, here we come. I might have some more questions for you later.
And I...
Let's get the hell out of here.
Hello?
What is the access code?
Let me and Headmaster block in. Headmaster, if you please. Plus, you notice he's not actually saying the access code anymore. Well, yeah. Okay, Headmaster Block's going to use the access code.
Ahem!
Duh.
Would you please let me and Headmaster Block in?
I only heard the footsteps of one person.
469-41.
Oh, pardon me, Headmaster Block.
Yeah, we're walking quietly. Wait, pardon me, guys. I'm pretty tired. It's really late, so... Ta-da, we're in!
The fire's just embers. Wish I had some potatoes.
Are those good with embers?
It's, quarter after... 12:33. The inauguration ceremony with the Archmage will be held here tomorrow morning at 9:00 standard time. That would be 87 minus 12 in the morning, and... I've just a couple of hours until the school's inauguration. I'm not sure I'd enjoy flying on a broom like that. I'm a little afraid of heights, and when I look at the handle, I can't imagine that it'd be comfortable to sit on.
You need a Nimbus 2000. Where's the rat hole?
That must be the rat hole Tim used to get in. I didn't even notice it this afternoon. I think that's why rats make such good intelligence operatives. Nobody pays them any mind. I guess Timmy's already looked in the rat accessible files. He found the door code in one of them.
Oh, I have a quill we can take?
Blocky won't mind if I borrow his pen.
Oh, for the magic script.
He probably would. But he doesn't need to know.
We're past the point of no return, Wilbur.
If I put the pen back early tomorrow, it won't be missed.
And there's that.
Right then. Blocky was fiddling with this straw when I surprised him. A small bottle. What's this? A letter. Dear Council Leader Van Buren, rest assured of my fullest support during the election campaign. Nevertheless, as headmaster, it is my duty to point Article 47, Paragraph 6 of the school rules out to you. Advertising of any form is prohibited in the school, and I must insist that the entire campus be left out of the electoral campaign. And now, the final inventory list for the ground floor of the school. Then there's a list of all sorts of objects, although it appears Headmaster Block isn't quite finished yet. I'm impressed. The headmaster forbids advertising in school, even if it is for Van Buren's campaign. Law and order seem more important to him than personal benefit. And yet he tries to badger me out of the school. Strange.
Maybe he genuinely doesn't like us. Did we keep, we put that back, right? Yeah.
The only thing in this drawer was this bottle.
Could it be dragon sweat?
Spidery old-fashioned writing, hard to decipher. Dragon sweat.
Da-da-ling.
Dragon sweat! What is the probability of the headmaster having the one ingredient for magic ink in his drawer that I couldn't find anywhere else?
I don't know.
Talk about luck.